Hi everybody, and welcome to the finale of the Sonic the Hedgehog 3. We're finishing this game right here, right now. Or rather, well, technically not right here, right now. I had this part finished, actually like a week or so ago, but I had some technical difficulties and I just generally couldn't bother to get it uploaded until actually the day this is going up, so yeah. Regardless, this is Lava Reef. It's actually fairly different compared to Sonic's version of the zone, especially in the second act, which we'll see later. Here you have to be very careful with your timing, or you're gonna wind up crushed before you can hit that button there. Anyway, this part is, I hate this part, to be honest. You have to glide with pretty good precision in order to make it to that little piece of the level without losing the lives. Or life, or couple. I probably would have died there if I hadn't had invincibility at that point. As for this boss, while these things will shoot things at them and you can't at you and you can destroy them, they're not what you want to. They're not what you want to attack, really. What you do want to attack is this hand here. Watch it carefully when it stops, be out of the way and be ready to jump on it. It's kind of hard to see those pellets, so I don't blame you if you kind of die a couple times like I did. You kinda have to focus when you get to the hand part here, because it's kinda easy to be thrown off and wind up getting hit by it. Anyway, that's pretty much it in regards to this particular mini boss. Then we have cleared Act 1. Act 2 of Lava Reef Zone, however, is very, very different from Sonic's run through, well, for the most part. Since Knuckles can't jump that high. Can't take the platforms up, so we have to take these two down to this area. Do what I'm not doing. Have some patience with your climbing this section here. Anyway, dodge these pillars of fire, at least better than I'm doing, and there's a bunch of spike balls to dodge. So yeah, you really want to stay alert here. You can get on these platforms, unlike the other one, by simply gliding against the wall or taking that spike. And we're in Hidden Palace Zone for about the next 10 seconds or so. Yeah, it's not even a level, it's a passageway. This is our final boss here. In what little remains of Sky Sanctuary Zone. You can't stop Egg Robo here from picking you up, so don't bother. Yeah, at least they give you rings here. And you have to fight Megasonic for the first phase of the fight. He shouldn't be, to be honest, he shouldn't be all that hard considering that, he's pretty much the same as the Sonic. I could probably be going at him faster, but it gives up more for us, I guess. It's still a fairly simple fight. Until he does it. And it's Super Megasonic. And yes, that's what it's worth. Check Sonic quite well. Anyway, he usually doesn't do this ready. he usually doesn't do his Rammy attack that often. Spin dash attack. He usually does that that golden fireball attack, and he powers down for a brief second so he can hit him. He's a missile otherwise. And you kind of bash on him until he hops on the map and powers up. This fight is not really that bad of practice. I think I'm making it record it actually. And now he's shooting a rage. He's shooting rage for some reason that harmed you. Now last one's gonna take you out. I think you hit him really like two more times after he starts his attack. And again, I'm making it look a lot harder than it actually is. And that wraps the game up. I'll quickly go over my final boss. I consider this to be honest, my favorite Sonic game, at least in the case of the classic series. There really is a lot to do in this one. Not only are the levels a joy to play, there are a lot of secrets to uncover and. Basically, a lot of good old-fashioned Sonic platforms. I can't say enough good about this game, to be honest. In fact, the special stages in this game are probably the only ones I've ever completed, other than the ones in the 3DS version of Sonic Generations. Although I've only completed the former once, and I just used the cheat codes that are numerous here, so enjoy, I guess, to get Super or Hypersonic. Regardless, it's pretty clear that I love this game, and I always will. The rest of the credits. This is Adrian Campbell signing off for Highlight Productions. Be sure to comment, like, and subscribe for more. And we're clear.